Well, Thanksgiving has come and gone, but that turkey hangover is likely still lingering. WNCT's Zora Stevenson is feeling the burn to help you shed the calories of holiday meals past.
I hope everyone enjoyed their Thanksgiving holiday. Now we're presented with the daunting task of trying to burn it all off. Here is a list of just some of the calories in all of our Thanksgiving favorites. But don't worry, we're in this together, and I've got some friends who are going to show us how to get back on track.
I got a circuit set up, and what we're going to do is we're going to go over this, and this will kind of demonstrate how many times you'd have to go through this or how long you'd have to go through this to burn off the average Thanksgiving meal.
All right.
You excited? All right. Awesome. Five.
So we just did deadlifts. Mm-hmm. Now we've got sit-ups.
Yep. Four. Five. Good. All right. Now we go burpees. Just holding on to those each time.
Okay. I'm officially sweating now. What's next?
We got kettlebell swings. We got 10 of them. This is my favorite part, so let's have fun. Here we go. Two and done. Great job. Five box jumps. Let's go. Five. Good.
Rower now.
10 calories on the rower. Good job. All right. One more thing. All right. Down and back. Let's do it. Probably burn off around 40 to 50 calories in those 2.5 minutes.
Not even a dent. That means you'd have to go through this circuit 23 times just to work off Thursday's feast. And Thanksgiving isn't the only thing we have to worry about this holiday season. Statistics show people gain 7 to 12 pounds during this time of year. But the folks at Fit for Life have some advice.
Get up each day, move as much as possible, get into the gym, do some cardio, do some strength training.
So the holidays come with a lot of calories, a lot of carbs. The moral of the story is stay as active as possible and everything in moderation. Happy holidays. In Greenville, Zora Stevenson, not on your side.